Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk a little bit more about RMEs, RAPEs, Hyrax expanders, anything that is a fixed kind of screw lock, kind of jack screw, kind of expansion device, whatever you want to call it, RPE, RME, palatal expander, I don't really care, it's all the same thing to me. So normally there's a little jack screw in here that you turn, and I actually have an entire video, well, I have an entire playlist just on RPEs and palatal expansion phase one and all that. This is more of an advanced video, so if you want to learn more about expansion, the different types, writing the lab slip, how to design it, please watch all my videos. The best way to get that is two different ways. Number one, go to your YouTube channel, put in Straight Smile Solutions in the top search bar. That takes you to my YouTube channel, which has a green banner. If you scroll down, I believe the second playlist is a phase one interceptive playlist. There's over 150 videos in there, tons of them on different types of expanders, fixed, removable, Schwartz, sagittal, you name it. So specifically the ones I'd like you to watch is just basically, well, everything on expansion, but there's one about jack screw design and how to pick the right jack screw. Make sure you watch that. If you just want to watch only that video and not search through the whole playlist, you can go to your YouTube channel. Go to my YouTube channel the same way. And then there's a little magnifying glass kind of towards the top right, tiny little magnifying glass on every YouTube page. That's the search phase. And then you put in there jack screw, and that should bring up my jack screw video within my channel. So anyways, the question is, should you lock your expander? And that's a great question that I really can't answer. That really is a question for your own lab guy. So talk to your lab tech and let them know if you should lock it, because I don't know what type of jack screw he's using. There are jack screws that do unravel, and there's jack screws that have locking mechanisms. And the ones that I used to use 20 years ago were not as well made as they are now. And sometimes they would, well, two things would happen. I mean, I think sometimes the parents kept turning, even though I told them not to. So I started later taking the key away so that they wouldn't do it. I don't know why. Maybe they think, oh, it's better if we keep going. And some of them want to punish the kid and keep going. They didn't understand that there's a reason we stopped turning. But there's also sometimes when I definitely took the key away and it would just unravel and I didn't know why. So like I said, depends on, ask your lab tech. I guess a lot of it depends on the quality of the lab and the materials that they're using, but that's a great question to ask if it's self-locking or not. If it's not, or you think you're using a cheaper lab, or if you're not using a lab in the US, you might want to consider locking it. Because I'm assuming the materials aren't quite as good. So that just means taking a little blob of composite and smushing it in the locking mechanism. The only reason I don't love doing that is because sometimes they relapse a little bit. And we decide, like, you know, 2 months into the retention phase of the expansion that we want to turn some more, you know, as the bite settles. And then if you lock it like that, it's permanently locked. There's nothing you can do. So then you have to remake it. So I don't do that anymore for that reason. But I also use good materials that don't unravel. And I do make sure that I have the right parent and I take the key away. And if I have a parent that I don't fully trust, there's some wackadoodles out there. And this has definitely happened to me before. Or one where maybe they didn't show up to the appointment and I'm not sure if the communication got to them, or it's a situation where maybe we have two parents, divorced family, one person's doing the turns on Thursday, one person's doing the turns on Saturday, and I'm not sure that all of us are incommunicado, we'll go ahead and lock it then just to be safe. Hopefully that helps. Thanks so much.